Today, we are pitting two smart controllers against each other, the Touptek StellaVita and the ZWO ASIAIR. These compact devices promise to simplify your astrophotography and let you control everything wirelessly. But which one is the ultimate brain for your astro leg? Well, let's dive in and find out. Imagine replacing your bulky laptop with a small box that handles all your telescope's commands. That's what these devices do. They act as the central control hub, letting you manage your entire setup wirelessly from your phone or tablet. Touptek StellaVita, this is Touptek's smart astrophotography wireless controller. It's built on an open ecosystem, meaning it aims to work with any equipment from any brand, not just Touptek. ZWO ASIAIR, the first launch in 2018, the ASIAIR quickly became a hit for making astronomical photography so simple. ZWO has since released several versions, including the popular ASIAIR Mini and the more advanced ASIAIR Plus, each designed for different needs. Both controllers are packed with essential features, but they have their unique strengths. Let's talk about imaging modes. Both offer standard single shot video and advanced scheduled shooting for automatic sessions. ASIAIR truly shines with this live stacking feature. This lets you see deep sky objects build up in real time on your screen, reducing noise and giving you instant gratification, perfect for EAA, electronically assisted astronomy. StellaVita offers real-time preview as well, but ASIAIR's live stacking is more integrated and highlighted feature for EAA. What about polar alignment? Well, both guide you to align your telescope mount with the celestial pole. They both use plate solving. ASIAIR claims to have better pole alignment features, but to be honest, they are about the same. In terms of autofocus, both help you get pinpoint sharp stars. The ZWO ASIAIR offers accurate focus features, letting you pick a star and get precise focus by looking at things like brightness. The Touptek StellaVita supports autofocus by first controlling the motorized focuser in video mode to get a rough, clear image from the main camera. It then switches to single frame mode for a test shot, which then the system analyzes. The system also gives you advice on the best gain and exposure settings to help with autofocus. How about guiding? Well, both provide stable auto guiding. There is not much difference, to be honest. ASIAIR has a longer history of software refinements in this area. In terms of go-to and plate solving, both of these devices are very capable to perform the go-to and plate solving task. They both do a fine job. Well, both controllers excel at automating your imaging sessions, allowing you to set up complex sequences and even handle meridian flips automatically. The ASIAIR's auto run function is highly praised for enabling unattended automated images session, even with multiple targets. StellaVita, being newer, still ironing out the issues with frequent updates. These little boxes are built tough for outside use, but how do they connect all your gear? Well, let's first talk about the design. Both feature durable aluminum bodies. ZWO ASIAIR line shows continuous refinements, with the Plus model being thinner and lighter than its predecessor, maintaining a consistent premium look. StellaVita is also compact and well-regarded. Well, what about ports? Well, both offer multiple USB ports, USB 3.0 and USB 2.0, and several 12 volts DC power outputs for your camera, mounts, and accessories. StellaVita has a higher overall power input, which is 12 volts and 8 amps. This means StellaVita can theoretically handle more total power. However, both brands limit individual output ports to 3 amps. And ZWO clearly warns against powering large mounts or high-power cooled cameras directly from the ASIAIR. This shows a common limitation among these small controllers. While they greatly reduce cable clutter, users with very power-hungry equipment might still need separate power solutions. ASIAIR Plus models include a dedicated USB-C port for fast image downloads to your computer, and newer versions even have Bluetooth for your wireless mount control, reducing cable clutter even further. StellaVita's USB-C port was noted as inactive during initial testing. In terms of Wi-Fi, both feature dual-band Wi-Fi 2.4 GHz or 5 GHz with similar claim ranges, which is around 20 meters. However, some StellaVita users suggest an external USB Wi-Fi adapter might be needed for better range and stability due to a hardware limitation. ZWO has actively improved its internal Wi-Fi antennas in the ASIAIR Plus for a more stable connection. What about storage? Well, ZWO ASIAIR Plus stands out with the substantial 256 gigabytes internal storage, which offers significantly faster data transfer, up to 2.5 times faster compared to older models. StellaVita relies on internal storage or external SD cards for primary image storage. This is a crucial decision point. Do you want an open system that plays well with everything or a tight, integrated, brand-specific one? Well, StellaVita champions an open ecosystem. This is fantastic if you already own a mix of equipment and want the freedom to choose different brands in the future. ASIAIR is primarily designed for ZWO ecosystem. It offers full compatibility with all ZWO ASIAIR cameras, filters, focuses, you name it. While it supports selected Canon, Nikon, and Sony DSLRs, it explicitly states that it will not work with other brand astronomy cameras such as QHY, including guide cameras. In terms of mount capability, both controllers offer extensive mount support. In terms of accessories, StellaVita's open system extends to accessories managing filter wheels, electric focusers from various brands like ZWO, QHY, CCD, Gemini. ASIAIR maintains its proprietary approach here, compatibility only with ZWO brand filter wheels and the ZWO EAF autofocuser. If you have non-ZWO accessories, well, you'll need to buy ZWO equivalent to use them with ASIAIR. How easy are these to use for beginners and pros, and what kind of support you can expect? Well, in terms of ease of use, ASIAIR is often praised for its extremely simple and intuitive app and a very fast learning curve, making it highly appealing for beginners. Many users say it worked on the first try. StellaVita also aims for simplicity, but some users find its layout a bit more technical compared to ASIAIR. While both complex systems can have quirks, StellaVita being newer is actually addressing bugs and missing features with regular updates. ASIAIR, despite its maturity, has seen reports of camera disconnections and even issues with defective ZWO USB 3.0 cables. However, ASIAIR has features like eMMC storage for OS stability and an auto recovery mode to self-fix issues. In terms of customer support and community, well, ZWO has a significant larger user base, meaning a vast community for peer-to-peer support and troubleshooting. ZWO's customer service is also often described as very responsive and efficient. While Touptek is quick with updates, potential logistical challenges for international repairs have been noticed. Finally, let's talk about the cost and what you get for your money. Well, Touptek StellaVita generally priced around $350 USD. ZWO ASIAIR Mini, a more budget-friendly option, is typically $200, $279 USD. ZWO ASIAIR Plus, 256 GB one, is competitively priced usually between $299 to $350 USD. In terms of value proposition, StellaVita's open system is a huge value if you want flexibility and don't want to be tied to one brand. This can save you money by using your existing gear or choosing more affordable components from different manufacturers. ASIAIR offers a highly integrated plug-and-play experience. If you are already invested in ZWO equipment or prefer a seamless, optimized workflow with strong community, ASIAIR provides excellent value, potentially saving you time and troubleshooting headaches. So the choice between the Touptek StellaVita and the ZWO ASIAIR comes down to your personal priorities and existing equipments. Choose StellaVita if you value an open ecosystem that works with a wide variety of cameras, mounts, and accessories, giving you maximum flexibility and potential cost savings. Choose ZWO ASIAIR if you're already invested in the ZWO ecosystem or you prioritize a highly integrated, streamlined, and generally more mature plug-and-play experience. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and let us know in the comments which controller you prefer and why. Please, guys.